Welcome back. I'm Nick, owner of Not Just Lumber. Today we're starting a new video series where we're going to go into detail of all of our equipment we use here at Not Just Lumber. Today we're going to start with our Idry Plus vacuum wood kiln. So a few details about this. We'll start with the exterior. So its size is 23 feet long, 93 inches wide, and 96 inches tall. It has an overall weight of 14,500 pounds. When we had this thing delivered, it came on a flatbed truck, and instead of us trying to figure out how to unload this thing and potentially drop it, we went the smart route and hired a rigging company to come in and unload it for us. They brought in a large forklift and moved it off the truck and got it positioned back here in the corner of our shop for us. And that was way easier for me to point a camera at them and watch them have the stress of trying to move this thing rather than us doing it for ourselves. And we purchased the Idry Plus model over a standard sized model for its increased capacity on the interior. So we take advantage of that extra interior by offering it as a drying service for our customers, as well as drying all of our lumber and slabs that we offer for sale up in the front retail section. So this increased capacity is 60 inches wide, 65 inches tall, and it will have 16 foot 8 inches in length. So this box here is constructed of 6-inch I-beams all the way around, and it has a 1/4-inch stainless steel plate on all the doors and all the interior. And if you notice in the back, there's a panel with gaps on either side. So there's a circulation fan behind that panel, as well as three electric heating elements, just like your oven would have. So that fan circulates the air through the chamber, and the stack that you put in there is on stickers, so it pushes the air through the stack, and the heating elements heat the air up to 160 degrees. So what makes this one different than a normal kiln is this is a vacuum kiln, so it draws a 20-inch vacuum on the interior of the chamber. So what that allows it to do is it lowers the boiling point of the water down to that 160 degrees, is able to turn that liquid inside your board into a vapor, and it actually escapes out the ends of the boards. So what that does is it keeps the ends of the boards wetter through the drying process, so it actually dries from the inside of the board out. So the ends will be the last part to get dry. And what that allows you to do is to dry thicker, wider material without as much risk of it splitting or checking or cracking. So we'll try to take you in here and get you a shot of that fan and elements. It's a little dark back there, so bear with us. So you may have noticed that there's an angle iron on the interior of the chamber, which leads to the outside, and we have a section of removable rails here before we get to our external trolley. So this system utilizes a frame that holds up our trolley. So this section right here is what rolls into the chamber. So there's V rollers on there to allow it to roll. So you may notice we have green ratchet straps with some, I guess they're porch swing springs. So these, we have one on each side of the strap, and that allows us to keep some downward pressure onto all the slabs while they dry, to try to minimize any sort of twisting or warping that they're gonna wanna do, which is unlikely in this system, but it doesn't hurt. So we have here we have stickers with a piece of plywood. So inside this chamber, all that moisture that comes out during the evaporation process condenses on all the exterior walls of the inside of that chamber. So if you don't have anything protecting the top board, all that water will drip off the ceiling and stain your top board. So we put those up there to direct the water over the pile. I think this pile here is ready to go inside the chamber, so I'll get the forklift and we'll slide it on in. As I mentioned earlier, this has a section of bed right here. These two beds come off, lay them on the floor, which allows clearance for our door to close. So you also may have noticed that we have a piece in the back here. So this we have to put in as a baffle so that the air doesn't just take this shortcut instead of forcing the air through the stack. So our door has a kind of a heavy door. maybe you can see it there. Has a hard rubber gasket. It has to be fairly stiff so that it doesn't get sucked in when we draw a vacuum on it. But that seals up against the end of the frame here. Then if I get over here, we have two hand wheels that'll suck down and it'll pull that gasket right against the face of the machine. And you just need to pull them up tight enough so that that gasket touches the face of the kiln. Because once you draw a vacuum on this, that'll actually suck that door right against the frame. And these hand wheels that are tight right now will become loose and you can actually move them back and forth. So now that this is all ready to go, let's take it to the back where the control panel is. And we'll give you a tour of that. So now we're at the back of the machine where most of the stuff happens. So right here we have our incoming power. This runs on a 230 volt, 60 amp circuit. So everything on this machine is electric, heating, and then we have a 3 horsepower vacuum pump here at the base of the machine. So this is a water cooled vacuum pump. And then moving up, we have a probe for the interior that gives us our relative humidity, and the red wires there are our electric heating elements. And then this vacuum line runs up to the top here where it enters the chamber, and then there's a muffler on the end so that when this goes into a drain cycle, it releases all the vacuum and then it pulls air in through that muffler, so it's not quite so loud. And then if you look at the bottom of the machine, we have another valve right there. And so every 24 to 48 hours you can adjust the time that it drains, intervals that it drains. That valve will open and it'll release the vacuum, and then any water that is accumulated on the inside of the chamber will get dumped out of that valve and go down the drain. All of the machine is run by a touchscreen panel, which is right here. So one of the things that I really enjoy about this machine is just how simple it is to run. There's not a lot of stuff that, you know, you can adjust or anything. So you have a start and stop. You can release your vacuum. You can check the status on everything, how long your vacuum pump runs. Make sure that you have cooling water for it. And when it goes into a drain cycle, you can see that everything's turned on or off as is needed. And then you have multiple graphs, so you can see your temperature. The blue line represents your vacuum level that you're drawn at, and then the green line would be your relative humidity for the inside of the chamber. So I hope you enjoyed our deep dive into our vacuum kiln. So our next up in our series is going to be our Cantex double-sided planer. So I hope to see you then.